I'm pleased to report there were no major oil leaks overnight. It's very slightly moist underneath the gearbox drain plug, but nothing else. The front and rear prop shafts are in now. In the past I've tried torquing them up. There's no torque setting listed in the manual, but I found one online, so I tried that and I found that the bolts just stripped. So I prefer just to tighten them up with a 9/16 spanner. What you can do is tighten them up using a special prop shaft socket, which you can buy for these, and then you do the rest with a spanner because the bolt head will grip on the prop shaft. Do them as tight as you can and that's about right. So as far as I can see, it's everything underneath done, and I can move on to fitting the seat box now. Well, I had a flash of inspiration and remembered the safe place where I'd put the plastic pipe. So I fished that out and I've come up with a better arrangement for my transmission breather. Basically, it follows the brake pipes down from the brake servo where it finishes up. I've tried to kind of shield the end of the pipe from any dirt, but it's got to come out somewhere fairly harmless. So it's just to the left of the brake servo. It comes down the brake pipes, branches across. There's a bracket that supports the clutch pipe, so I've taken off that along inside the gear selector, so it will run underneath the transmission tunnel onto the overdrive bracket. The T-piece I've put on the seat box, I think that starts about there, so the idea is that the pipe will come around and hook into it. I think actually it's got a 90 degrees, so it should go like that, so that would be quite neat. The T-piece, the three breather points here are branched into that on the 4mm pipe, and then the larger pipe takes any pressure away. I was finding that the breather, which I situated about there, wasn't high enough above the boxes, particularly the overdrive. They tend to churn the oil out, so there was quite an oil mist coming out and running down the bottom of the seat box, in turn onto the gearbox, and it was getting sprayed around everywhere. So this should cure that, I think. Should help keep the oil in the box on longer runs. Just time for one last photo call before we put the seat box back. Well, I've been pretty busy over the last few hours. Got most of the interior back in. I've bolted it in with the seat box, bolted it in with stainless bolts. Some people don't like that, because you're introducing another different metal. The Permarite bodywork always reacts with steel bolts, so I don't really see that it makes a lot of difference, and at least you can get these ones out to replace them. So I've used them in quite a few places. I haven't found anything to be a problem, so long as it can't trap water. So to that effect, I've been using plenty of seam sealer. Obviously I'll have to clean up around the edges when I've finished, but it's just helping to stop rattles, keep the water out. This is pretty much back in one piece now. Just got to sort through the spares and fill up the toolbox again. Something else I can get out of the house. Still got no workshop, but that's another video, hopefully very soon. So you can see the breather set up. There's a T-piece up there, and it all links up to another T-piece there, and the larger pipe then runs down the transmission tunnel like I showed you earlier, and up to the brake servo area. So I've also reattached the overdrive lever and set that up so that it doesn't collide with the gear lever, selector lever. The floor's all in, sealed up. Used as many new bolts and fixings as I can. And actually it's gone together very nicely, much better than it was before, so a little bit of care goes quite a long way with that. Last time I put things back, I just slapped it all together. So if we have a look underneath, I think you'll agree it looks an answer like smarter than it used to.
So that's a bit of a result.
done 23 miles. Seems right. It's slightly noisy, bearing in there somewhere, but it'll probably quieten down over time. It goes really well through the gears, so just got to have the carburetor off now, sort that out. It won't tick over, so not without choke anyway. Well, I just thought before I sign off, I'll have a quick look and check for leaks. The only one I can see is, well, there are two I can see. Nothing dreadful at all. It's either the pipe fitting that's leaked a bit there, or the cover. That should really have a thick cork gasket, so I might try changing that. That's nice and easy. The rest of it seems fine. I'd say it's a little bit cooler than the old transmission was after a 20 mile run. There's a slight leak that comes down the sides of the box, about there, maybe a bit further forwards actually. It drains down to the sump plug on the bottom of the gearbox and drips off there. I say drips, it hasn't actually dripped yet, it's only a very small amount. I think that's just passing the selector seals, and that's pretty much par for the course for one of these. So, pretty good. Well pleased with that. So as you can see, pretty clean. Hope you've enjoyed this series of videos. And thank you very much for watching.